the administrative units that had been set up by the Kabaka in Bururi or Bugerere should be left to those people. So the people in Bururi will not be dispossessed. Those two places, it was agreed in the, it's in the agreement.
Thereafter, the central government returned the Ebyaffe to Buganda, including 213 land titles. Nyombi said the Kabaka should hand over the properties in these areas.
Because the titles are in the names of the Kabaka, and there is no way you can transfer those titles unless the Kabaka signs the transfers. So that will be that is going to be done.
Buganda Kingdom has scoffed at the Attorney General Peter Nyombi for asking the Kabaka to hand over land titles in Bugerere and Bururi to the indigenous communities.
I think they were handed over to the Kingdom of Buganda because they belong to Buganda. What we are saying that if the Baruri or Wanyarawo or whoever, if they built their cultural institutions somewhere, then they are free to have those titles. But the Saza chiefs or the Gombola headquarters, which were built by Uganda Kingdom, there is no way we can surrender them to the Banyala or the Baruri.
This agitation amongst the Banyala and the Baruri communities could reignite the historical rivalry between Buganda and Bunyoro. The Bunyoro Kingdom, which is yet to get its properties returned by the government, steered the troubled waters, saying Buganda should return the 5 counties which were grabbed by the colonialists.
So you cannot accuse Bunyoro of creating a rift or hatred because they adhered or they implemented the constitutional act.
As far as we are concerned, we have no problems with the Bunyoro. Not at all. I've seen not once, not twice, so many times, actually over 20 times, I've seen the Mukama of Bunyoro here in Buganda.
Omukama Iguru's publicist Ford Minima says the boundaries should be redrawn.
So when the kingdom says want the boundaries to be restored, that's what they mean. Those boundaries should be restored. We need our counties back. There are 7 of them. The Bugangaizi, Buyaga, those have been restored, but then there remain the others, like Buhekura, like Bururi, like Bunyara, that is Bugerere, like Rugonjo, that is Northern Singo, and Bulemezi, again Northern Bulemezi, those are still in Buganda. And the Banyoro are demanding their return.
However, the Buganda Kingdom spokesperson Dennis Walusimbi Sengendo said it would be a futile exercise to attempt rewriting history.
The boundaries of Buganda, they are properly demarcated and defined in the constitution of this country. Are you going to change the constitution? For example, you take, there is a place here in Katwe. It's called Katwe Chinyoro. There is also a place in Kamoja. It's called Chifumbira. There is also a place in Entebbe here. It's called Muchitoro. Because there are so many Batoros there are so many Bafumbiras there. Now, if they start claiming that that's not part of Buganda.
Walusimbi said the question of the contested counties was settled in 1995 constitution. Minima also asked the Kabaka to return land titles he owns in Bunyoro.
By the way, most of them have accepted the compensation, except people like the Kabaka of Buganda is holding about 8 miles there. He refused to hand over those land titles. But yes, he has got a land title. He's got a land title. And the Uganda Constitution, 1995 Constitution, asks him to surrender that title and he gets his compensation. But he refused. So as of now, he's holding on our land.
So what is wrong if a Muganda has got a title in Bugisu or in Bunyoro? You can do your research. There are non-Buganda here with titles. They own square miles here in Buganda. We are not talking about it. And they are free to own it. Why should they say that the Kabaka or Muganda cannot own land in Bunyoro? The boundaries of Buganda are clearly defined. So are the boundaries of Bunyoro, you know. And I think everybody is free to own land in any part of this country.
In 1964, the counties of Buyaga and Bugangayizi reverted back to Bunyoro after referendum. The return lit the spark which culminated into the 1966 crisis during the Obote I regime. Jingo Francis, NTV Weekend Edition.